God is so good to us, isn't He? He is a wonderful Lord. I'm just so glad to be saved. I don't know why the Lord chose a guy like me to stand before you. But it just proves that if God can use me, He can use anybody else. It's just good to be saved, isn't it? Now while the choir is getting ready and they're working on me back in the back to sort of get me ready here, I want you to open your Bibles to St. John chapter 5. St. John chapter 5. And you've heard most of it read earlier. And I'm going to be talking along these lines for the next month or so. Now, beginning again at verse 5. Chapter 5, verse 5. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years. When Lord Jesus saw the man lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he said unto him, will you be made whole? I thought this is interesting to move. The impotent man answered, he said, well, sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool. On the line there. I have no man. But while I am coming, another steps down before me. Jesus said unto him, rise and take up your bed and walk. Now, I'm coming, so you just hang. The impotent man, laying by the pool, Lord Jesus looks at the man and said, take up your bed, rise, take up your bed and walk. I'm coming. Verse 9. And immediately the man was made whole and took up his bed and walked. And on the same day, was the Sabbath. Let's keep moving. Let me work with it while they do. Keep working. What you can do? I want to talk with you today about this. Rise and be made whole.
Amen.
It's nuts what you see happening here. It's nuts. Don't try to figure it, okay? Yeah. All right, let's just go with it. Are you with me?
Amen.
Listen, to an impotent, rise and be made whole. Watch this. Now, the subject itself is like making a very powerful statement, and it's making a direct implication to all of us here today. It's actually talking to the church as well. It's saying something, I think, it's making a bold, it's making a faith, not a faith bold, but it's making a faith statement. Rise, watch this, rise and then, parenthetically, rise and then be made whole.
Yes.
Now let it be clear in your mind. Now you got to hear me on this. Let it be clear in your mind that we're talking about mending the brokenness of your life. A lot of folk in this room here have some things that we're going through. There's some things broken within our lives. Doesn't mean that we ain't gonna count. It just means that there's some stuff that is tough. Some things that are very difficult for us to deal with. Like our brother and sister-in-law who just lost their son. They just buried him this past Saturday. And they are broken this morning. There are always gonna be some things that we're gonna be challenged with. You know, and I think that these broken things, you know, like, you know, your body is sick, you need to be healed. I think all of these things, your wounds, resolving your shortcomings, resulting into being made whole, simply means that though you're going through those tough things, that there is still an answer for you, there's still a way out. You can still come. You can still live in the midst of what you're going through. Does anybody agree with that?
Man.
Are we going to be challenged in life?
Yes.
Everybody got, you got some stuff you just going to deal with.
Right.
I'm going to say it now. Here, let's be real.
Right. Yes.
Now, let me bust your bubble. Just because you're saved does not mean you ain't going to go through some stuff. I think I'm going through this now. I think that you don't really start going through hell until you really make up your mind.
Amen.
That you want to get saved. You follow me? That's when I think hell really breaks out. Can I cuss a little bit? Hell really breaks out, I think, in a believer's life. The moment he decides, by God, I don't have to take this anymore. I'm going to change things. Then here comes the opposition. Now, obviously, to rise simply means to be lifted up, elevated to a higher plane than where you are right now. That's simple. It means really to get up. Somebody say, get up.
Yeah.
It means to get up from where you are. Now, our subject implies that whatever down or fallen state that you're in, whether it's physical sickness, whether it's emotional duress, whether it's financial or economic, whether you're financially or economically distraught, whatever it is, you know, you can get up from it, you can rise above it, but watch this, That's what the text is saying here. Get up, rise above it, and watch this. And then, somebody say, then. Then you can be made whole, complete, restored, or well. It's interesting. Get up and then be made whole. But now the point of the thought in the minds of those, you know, in such down and fallen state, could, I think, it could very well be, well, if I had the ability to get up, I had the ability to rise above where I am, I wouldn't have been here in the first place. That's simple, right? If I had the ability to get up from where I am and to do something better than what I'm doing, I wouldn't have been here in the first place. Would I? Anybody like being down?
No.
If you do, that's some medication for you. This going to help you what I'm giving you. Nobody likes to be down. So I want to say that some people thrive on sympathy. Some people just, they crave sympathy. One lady killed 7 of her 8 children so that people could say, oh, I'm so sorry for you. She thrived on that. She was a sick woman. She needed some medication at penitentiary time.
So,
well, let's see what Jesus said in verses 1 through 4, okay? He said, in verse 1 through 4, watch this. Of James. Are you there?
Yeah.
Did I tell you to go there? Okay, I'm sorry. Don't go to James. Just stay here. In verses 1 through 4, listen. After this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up into Jerusalem. Now there is, at Jerusalem, by the sheep market, a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue, Bethesda, which means it has 5 porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind and halt, which was lame. They were withered in certain places, and they were waiting for the moving of the water. Now you underline it in your Bible. They were waiting for the moving of the water. A miracle. For an angel went down at a certain time and went by the pool, and he troubled the water, and whoever was the first one to get into the troubling of the water, if you stepped in there first, you were healed of whatever disease that you had. Now tradition has it that each year, around New Year's, every year, an angel would go down, he would be dispatched from glory and from heaven, and he would go down into Jerusalem. And there, he would enter into this pool, and he would disturb the water. He would ripple it a little bit. And such disturbance would let those know that it was time for them to get inside the water. And the first person that would step into the pool, tradition has it, was made whole. Now, you know, depending on how sick you were, there'd be some situations around that pool, wouldn't there?
Yeah. Yeah.
You trying to get in there, and there's somebody else sick?
Yes.
And they've been waiting there. And if I had been waiting there for 38 years, it's serious around the pool.
Right.
Can I give a good amen?
Yeah.
I said, can I give a good amen?
Yeah.
I know you're Holy Ghost filled, but you've been sick 38 years.
Right.
You get in that pool.
Yeah.
Hold on, player. Am I right?
Yeah.
That's it. Now, it didn't matter whether such occurrence was really divine, you know, whether it was really a God thing or not. It was in their minds. It was in the minds of those people around that pool that they expected it, they awaited it, and they believed that if when that trouble was water, if I get in there first, I got my healing. I was always concerned what happens if 2 feet hit the water at the same time. Who gets the blessing? And so in verse 5, I want you to read what happens here. Everybody, let's read it together. You close your Bibles. You close your Bibles. Look at verse 5. Let's read it together. Ready? 3. And a certain man was there, what? Which had a sickness. How long?
38.
Say it again. How long?
38.
Now, ain't that a long time to put up with something?
Amen.
Now, watch this. And we're complaining about something that ain't happened for us in the last 2 years or 6 months ago. Here's a cat that's been down for how long?
38.
There's a point to be made there. This certain man believed. He believed. Somebody say he believed.
He believed
in this occurrence. And several times he tried to be first person to step in that water. And because of his mindset, here Jesus in verse 6, look what he says. I want you to read that. Ready? Read. When Jesus saw him lie, read, and knew that he had been a long time there, that case, he said unto him, what? Now that's an interesting question. I would ask the same question. Will you be made whole? Why would you ask me that question? Because you're here for 38 years? But it also seems like there's something like rhetorical. You know, it ain't his rhetoric. It ain't something that he was supposed to answer. I guess the Lord was saying, you've been here 38 years. You must not want to be here.
Well,
you got something you've been dealing with for 38 years, and you got an opportunity. Here's what you believe in, and you ain't got out of it yet. There's something wrong. So somewhere. So the Lord walks up to him and says, do you really want to be made well? The guy might have cussed.
Yeah.
Listen, what do you think I've been out here all this long time for? And who you anyway? Right?
Well.
So please hear Jesus now. It's obvious that the man wanted to be well because every year, for some time now, he'd been waiting at that pool. But he couldn't beat the other people getting in there because he was crippled.
Right. Amen.
So that's almost understandable. But in his mind,
yeah.
If he could just get into that water, when it was trouble, he'd be made whole.
Yeah.
In his mind, he thought that the only way I'm going to get my healing is I got to be the first one in that water. In his mind, he thought that. Stay with me. And so Jesus deals with this certain crippled man within his own mindset, within where this cat was in his head. The man believed that he could be healed, but
yeah.
He only believed he could be healed on a certain condition. He knew that he could be healed. Look at me. He knew that he could be healed, but he thought he could only be healed under certain conditions. Oh, I know I can get it, but only if I send the $99 off of the prophecy in New York. I know I can be healed. I'm freeing up some people. I know I can be healed, but I got to stand up here, and when he touches me on my head, I got to fall prostrate on the floor and be covered up with some records. I know, I'm right where you are, because I'm teaching you that we have all kinds of mindset. We believe that we can get the things that we desire, the things that we need, but we got to be in the right place at the right time when the miracle tent revival is here and the man, the woman of God says we're having a miracle healing session on next Thursday night and y'all will leave here and get in those long lines, but correct me if I'm wrong. If that is the only place and the only time that the woman has been told that you could be healed, it seems to me if you got that kind of power to heal down the street, you should go to First Health first and heal everything there.
Yes.
Bring your
yes.
Mister to the test.
Yes.
I know it's tough, but hang with me. I know because y'all, my sister went off and bought some prophecy. Watch this.
Really?
He did have hope. The man had hope. He did have desire to be healed, but his mindset was limited to his ability and hindered his being made whole. So his mindset was limited to where he was. I would like to be the first one in the water, but because of where I am, I just can't get there. I can't do it. I want to go there, but look at me. I'm crippled. My legs all drawn up. I want to have this. I want to go there. I want to do this, but I got some stuff that's holding me down. And that's why the Lord had to go right straight to where his head is. The Lord had to go to him and say, I know where you are, you know where you are, but do you really want to be made well?
Yes.
Just go ahead and suck it in just for a minute. I'm coming. So here the man in verse 7, I want us to read that again. Are y'all still there?
Yes.
Look at verse 7, let's read together. Read. The impotent man answered him, but sir, I have no one when the water is troubled to put me into the pool. But while I'm coming now, there's another joker that steps down, and he says, sir, no, you know, and so the Lord, he said, no, I want to get well. So his mind was, yes, I want to come out of where I am, but I ain't got nobody to help me to come out.
Mm-hmm.
I want to come out of where I am. I don't want to be like I am, but there's nobody trying to help me to come out of where I am.
Yeah.
Well, Jesus said, do you want to be well? Yes, I want to be well. They cut back my stakes. They lay my hours off at my job. No, we're not talking about that. Do you want to be whole?
Yeah.
But I ain't got nobody to help me. You know, I can't even get to work. Ain't nobody gonna give me a ride.
You ain't got to say nothing. Just say this.
Nobody will give me a ride. That's not, do you want to be made whole? Yes, but. Here's the but. The but casts out everything that comes out.
Yes.
I want, but.
Okay.
I want, but. I believe, but. Are y'all hearing me? Anybody with me?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Yes, I know that you're there. So he casts out everything. So the man was focused on his physical inabilities. He was focused on his physical impairment. He couldn't see beyond his own natural strength. He couldn't see beyond his own physical capabilities.
Well,
he was looking for somebody else to carry him in. He was looking for somebody else to bail him out. He was looking for somebody else to put him ahead of them. But look, most everybody that was standing around You can't look for somebody else to help you when everybody else is mad at you. I know the telephone call. I get so many calls, and I be monitoring. I'm smart enough now. I've learned to read the, you know, the incoming calls. I can tell now. I'm technology. I can read a little bit. And I see who's calling. I say, well, not today. Praise the Lord. Because I know it's going to be a complaint. I know it's going to be a cry of a pastor, please. And we done prayed about this 16 times.
Yeah.
And here you come around again. And so, look, the man wanted to be well, but he was looking for somebody else to feel sorry for him. But there was none, for everybody was too busy trying to get help for themselves. Ain't nobody got time to carry you and carry themselves as well. Am I talking to a church?
Yeah.
She won't give you a ride. She's tired of giving you a ride. She's been riding you around for 2 years now. By now, you ought to at least have a stool up. Help me out here. He looked beyond the man's crippling state. Let me see where I'm going. The man was in a young crippling state and saw a healthy mind. He looked at the man's physical condition. Cut this on, son. Okay. He looked beyond the man's physical state and he saw a healthy mind. Somebody say, a healthy mind.
A healthy mind.
Say it again, a healthy mind.
A healthy mind.
Now, he was crippled in his body, but Lord Jesus knew there wasn't a thing wrong with his mind. Now you know where I'm going, right? So you can leave now because you're going to get deep in just a second. Now watch this. So Jesus spoke to the man's mind. Look at verse 8. And let's read it together. Verse 8. Ready? Read. Oh, good. Thanks. Thank you, see. Verse 8. Read. Jesus said unto him, what?
Rise.
Take up your bed. And do what? Underline that. Rise. Somebody say rise.
Rise.
Take up your bed and walk. Now watch this. If you want to be made whole, the Lord says, you got to get up. The man's mind was probably scanning a million cells in his head. He was going through every gigabyte that he had. Is gigabyte the right term? He was going through all the gigabytes. But he knows Jesus sees his condition. He knows, like, you got to see me, and yet you ask me to get up from where I am. I just got laid off, and you're telling me to stop complaining and get up from where I am. I can't make them hire me back at the job, and you're telling me to get up from where I am. He decided that he doesn't want to be married anymore, and you're telling me to get up? We got into this debt, this house together, and you're telling me to get up? My business partner has ruined me, and my business is headed towards bankruptcy, and you're telling me to get up?
Amen.
You see, Jesus knew that the man had to first see himself rise in his head before he could get up in the match.
Yes.
Because nobody in this room can ever outlive or outprosper your mindset. It ain't gonna happen. Wherever your mind is, that's where the rest of you gonna follow. Come on, say something. If your mind says you can't, you ain't. I'm sorry, come on. If your mind says that you cannot get up, you ain't getting up. So Jesus, now you know the Lord saw the man's crippled condition. He's the omniscient God. He knows everything. But when God looked at his condition, his physical condition, it seems to say to me that the physical condition somehow was an offshoot of what was in your head.
Yeah.
Maybe you're like you are because of the way you think.
Amen.
Maybe you're limited because the limitation first started in your own mind.
That's right.
Maybe you haven't got there yet because you keep holding back. You keep putting butt there, and the butt cancels out every effort that you got. You would have already overcome, but you keep saying butt.
Yes.
Seems to me you got to get your butt out the way. I couldn't resist. I had to throw it out. You guys, we got to know what are we learning so far, and I'm not going to finish it, but what are we learning so far? That we got to stop canceling out what we want. If you want it, don't put butt there. It seems that if Lord Jesus saw you laying by the pool, if the Lord sees you headed towards divorce, if God sees that your job is being cut down, if God sees that you're because he knows that it first has to be a desire. You got to first want to be well. You got to first want to get up from where you are. You got to first see yourself being where you want to be. Because if you can't see it in your mind, you can never get it. You got to first vision it. You got to first envision it. You got to see it. That's why I call Amway and some of these other businesses tell you to write your dreams down and put it on your refrigerator or put it on the dashboard of your car. Because as you frequent it, it changes the way you think. And Solomon said, as a man thinks, so is the man. So when you start seeing your vision and seeing your dream before you, then the dream becomes a part of your thinking. And as you think, you become. It doesn't matter what you look like. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter what pain you have. It doesn't matter how long you've been down there. The moment you say, I'm getting up from out of this mess, then that's when your renewal or your revival or your healing or your restoration of your wholeness begin. And even if it takes you 6 months or 6 years to get up from where you are, once you change your mind, all your circumstances begin to change as well.
Amen.
Can I get a good amen right now? When you make up in your mind, and I got so much to give you, but I can't give it all to you right now. Y'all broke me up late. But watch this. You got to want to be better than you are. And you cannot hold other people responsible for your failure. But Lord, they won't put me in the water. Ain't nobody supposed to put you in the water. You're a grown man. You're a grown woman. Get your own butt in there. You ought to be able to crawl to the edge of the water by then. I'd be crawled to the edge of the pond and have my finger right there. When the angel come, I would have been in this possible so long. I'd have had to do something else to get in there because my arm would have been froze there waiting on the water. As soon as the ropes, I'd have been in the water. I just think I can grow up better if I do this, or I can, I think I can do that. No, well, it ain't where you are, it's who you are.
Yes.
Because I can take you from here and take you to New York, and you'll be the same failure in New York that you are right here. Until you first win in your mind, you ain't gonna win in New York. Let me tell you something. Before you get back here next week, you got to write your dream down. You gotta write what you want out of life and where you're trying to go. Bring that with you next week. I want to know if you can see it in your mind. This is where I am going, and I am going to get there, come hell or high water. Yeah, I said it. Or high water. Sometimes radical things happen for radical people.
Amen.
Beggars never achieve. Doers achieve.
Yeah.
People who are looking for somebody to drag you along, you're too much dead weight. Nobody's gonna drag you anyplace. You got to carry yourself. You know, husbands can't even carry wives. Wives can't carry husbands. A lot of marriages break up because one is trying to carry the whole load. You gotta carry yourself. Stop telling people, well, I'm looking for my better half. No, better half ought to be you. Do you want to get your education? I don't care how old you are. Get the butt out of there. Do you want to finish college? You got to. I want to hear, yes! That's where it starts. It starts with what you want to do. Now, I'm going to leave that with you. Because when you come back, I'm going to go first. But they ain't going to do all the same. And then when they come back, we're going to get it. We're going to get it. No, I'm kidding you. They did well. They did very well. They did very well. But I got to get into your heads. All right? Ain't no sense in us sitting up here with our hands up in there, hallelujah, and you leave here broke. Ain't no sense in you shout in here, and I love to get a good shout going on. You know, I can play a little bit. I love to get a good shout going on. But ain't no sense of you shouting and going home, and you got one more week to get out of the house before the sheriff come pan out. What you shouting for? Here's what I want you to do. I want you to sometimes sit down and let's study the Word of God and learn something. Get a reason to shout. Get a reason to stand up here with your hands up. And stop crying all the time. I'm gonna wipe your tears away. God needs something to bless, and we gotta learn to give God something to bless. You just can't come here with dirty laundry every week and a wish list. God wants something to bless. God been sitting up here yawning, saying, I've been waiting on you for the last 38 years. So what we gotta do is wanna do it. No more excuses, say that with me. No more excuses, say it with emphasis. No more excuses. No more excuses. No more buts. We're gonna do this thing. First Missionary was about to do it. We got $250,000 project that we've been waiting on it for years. A lousy freaking $250,000. Two of y'all, husband and wife, in a house, one family, and you got a house cost more than that. Here we are, a little something like that. We just got standing that way? Never. So you know what I do? I don't care where y'all head is. I say, Lord, we're going to do this. We're going to do it, Lord. We're going to do it. No more buts. No more buts. Some of y'all been looking for your healing a long time. That boy right there been sitting there sick with some stuff. You don't even know what he has to go through. He never complained or cried. When you ask him how he's doing, I'm doing fine. Doing fine. Feel good. You know why? Because the healing starts here first. You got to see yourself as you want to be.
Yes.
I gotta stop. But let me tell you something. I'm looking at some successful people. I'm looking at some whole people. I'm looking at some people who are gonna learn. You've already learned over the years I've been teaching, but you're gonna learn to speak your destiny over yourself. You don't need nobody to come in here from out of town somewhere telling you to flop down in here so he can lay his hands on you. And you don't know where his hands. To know where you're going. Am I talking right to you?
Yeah.
You gotta know where you're going before you can get there.
Right.
You can't even set the navigator because you don't know where you're going. You gotta call someone on the telephone and say, what's the address?
Right.
So I can get in. You can't keep your navigator around 5th and 13th Street. Around. You got to know where you're trying to go. Talk to me.
Yeah.
You gotta know where you can't where you're going.
Yeah.
You know, you look at the chilling squad sometimes. I love chilling. How did she get on the cheering squad? All right? And then when they come out on the floor, that chick going somersaults, jumping 6 feet up in the air. They fall up to the ceiling and drop down. Why? Because she would not take no for an answer. She wanted to be a cheerleader. She didn't care if she was 4'8". I'm going to be a cheerleader.
If my voice sounds like this,
she's still going to say, go, go, go. And get all y'all fired up. You can do it if you first want to. I'm gonna stop this. I don't care if you're 7 years old. If you really always wanted to get a college degree, you can get one. The school right over yonder. You can, I mean, you're right. It's right over there. You can do it if you're 80 years old, if you wanna do it. Do you wanna be whole?
Yes.
I said, do you wanna be whole?
Yes.
Jump up on your feet and give God a great big God bless you.
say, if you hold me by now, it ain't gonna happen, though. Close in prayer is not gonna help you much anymore. But you leave this place with this word inside of you, you will be challenged to change your mind. Remember this, old things happen to be passed away. They don't just pass away because you said it. Oh, I'm getting too deep into next week. But just because you say it don't mean it's happening. All right, so you come back. Remember, you coming back with it just because I said it's over don't mean it's over. All right, so you come back in there next week, and by God, we're going to get the rest of the story. Hug somebody and say it's over.